Hello guys, welcome back to another video. So I don't usually make this type of video here on my channel, but I thought it was quite interesting. So the other day, Unity rolled out a new pricing system for the engine. Now, if you don't know what Unity is, it's basically a game engine similar to Unreal Engine. In fact, they are the direct competitor to Unreal Engine. They have millions of users and lots of popular games have been made on their engine. I'll put a couple of popular ones up here on the screen. But basically the other day, the company announced a new pricing model for people creating games with Unity. Now, you might be asking me, why is this important? I mean, we only do Unreal Engine content here on the channel, but bear with me. So if you are using Unity to develop a game, under their new licensing model, you have to pay per install, meaning if someone downloads your game, whether that game is free to play or paid, you now owe Unity 20 cents per install. So let me clarify, this is over the 100,000 install threshold. So you have to have over 100,000 installs of your game before you owe them, 20 cents per install. I mean, that's just insane. And someone even pointed out how outrageous this would be when you consider things like free-to-play games that were made inside of Unity. And even the user Danny, who is, a popular Unity developer here on YouTube, he tweeted out how much he would have to pay with this new licensing. Basically, he has these two games here on Steam with the combined downloads or installs of over 28 million. So a lot of people have installed his game. So if you take that amount and multiply it by 20 cents, it would cost them over $5 million in royalties that you'd have to pay to Unity as per their new licensing agreement. And mind you, these two games are completely free to play. As far as I know, he's not making any money off of it. He could have some, cosmetic items and stuff that he's selling on it, but the game is, free to play. That's just crazy. I mean, I do have to clarify that if he uses the pro license versus the personal license, he does get a little bit of a discount there. But even then, I mean, that's just an outrageous pricing system. And now that I think about that, I think the math is wrong here, because after 1 million, it would be a flat rate of 2 cents per install. So if you were to redo the math, I think you'd have to pay around 800K if he were to release these two games after the licensing change, or if a bunch of people decide to install this game in the future. Now, this licensing is absolutely terrible. I mean, it's a terrible pricing plan, and I think a lot of Unity users are going to just outright drop Unity and maybe even switch over to Unreal Engine. And I think that's where the Unreal Engine part comes into play here, because there are some very big implications of licensing in games. I mean, just from the examples here, you have devs are not going to be releasing demos because, that could count as an install. You have things like DRM free games, where if a user installs that multiple times, they now owe Unity tons of royalties in those installs. Things like bundles, giveaways, updates. I mean, there's so many different ways that you can distribute your game, and now, because of it, you're going to have to be paying all of those royalty fees. Now, to get into the Unreal Engine part of the video, let's actually pull up the Unreal Engine pricing, because I know a lot of you want to see how it compares to Unity. So basically how it works is Unreal Engine is 100% free to download for anyone. Anyone can download the engine right now and start making whatever you want with it. They basically have a royalty pricing model where after you've made over $1 million in gross revenue, only after that, the revenue after $1 million, you only have to pay 5% on that. So for example, if you make $1,001,000, you owe Epic Games 5 cents because you're only paying royalties on the dollar amount after $1 million in gross revenue. And the thing is, this doesn't even factor in all of the other things that Epic has. They even have a program where if you publish your game on the Epic Game Store, the revenue generated from the Epic Game Store will be excluded from that 5% royalty. So, I mean, you compare this to a platform like Steam, where you have to pay 30% of your game's revenue to Steam, whereas if you publish it on the Epic Game Store, you just don't even have to pay the royalty because you have your game sold on their store. And I mean, even recently, they announced a new program where you can release your game on the Epic Game Store, and they will give you 100% of the revenue generated on that game for the first 6 months, I believe. This is a brand new program that they just announced. And I mean, I could go on and on about all the different benefits of switching to Unreal Engine. I mean, the fact that Epic gives away 5 free asset packs every single month that you can use for your games, commercial or non-commercial. There's a massive library of things like pre-existing free assets called Quixel Bridge. And they have just tons of free assets on the Unreal Engine marketplace that you can use. I mean, the list just goes on and on. And basically, my opinion opinion on this whole thing is that the game engine industry, it does need to be competitive. I would hate to see Unity go bankrupt, basically. And I mean, it just seems like they've been on a downward spiral. I mean, they really are just shooting themselves in the foot with this new pricing system. I think a lot of folks are going to be switching over to Unreal Engine at this point. Now, if you are one of those folks who are in the Unity boat and you want to switch over to Unreal Engine, I have a bunch of free tutorials on how to get started using Unreal Engine, how to learn the user interface, how you can start learning Blueprints, which is Unreal Engine's proprietary scripting system. And I'm actually going to be remastering all these tutorials in Unreal Engine 5.3. So I think now has never been a better time to actually start learning Unreal Engine. There are so many things you can use the program for. Even if you're not going to be pursuing games, you can still use the engine and some of the stuff that you learn. Take those skills and you can even go into the film industry, you know, automotive industry. There's so many different career opportunities inside of Unreal Engine. And I mean, I've been with the engine since they released Unreal Engine 4. And in fact, back when they released Unreal Engine 4, it was an actual paid license. So you had to pay, I think, $20 a month just to use the engine. And since then, they made it completely free to use. And they've just been investing all of the money they've got back into the engine, developing new tools, giving away free assets, and just so much more. In fact, they even have a grants system. So if you are making a game, you can apply for an Epic Mega Grant, where they can help you build your game and give it that extra boost that it needs. But yeah, those are my thoughts on the new Unity pricing system. Like I said, I think a lot of folks are going to be switching over to Unreal Engine, or at least looking at Unreal Engine and trying to figure out how to use it. And so with that being said, I will be making a lot of Unreal Engine beginner tutorials. I also have some Unreal Engine courses on my website, smartpoly.teachable.com. So if you want to check them out, I'll leave a link in the description below. I have a complete course that shows you how to make a multiplayer survival game from scratch. It has over 70 hours of course content, 240 plus lectures, and I'm going to be adding more courses on the website in the future, so stay tuned for that. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next one.